Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are doing good. Children, as you all are aware that we were doing chapter 10 mensuration, and in our last class we have done perimeter of rectangle. Now today we are going to start with perimeter of regular shapes. Now regular shapes means that is made up of sides and all these sides were equal. Now here in this perimeter of regular shapes, perimeter of regular shapes, we are going to talk about regular shapes. We are going to talk about two. Here we are going to talk about square and equilateral triangle, square as well as equilateral triangle. So now why we were talking about a square? Since a square has all its four sides equal. Like if length of one side is 1 meter or 1 centimeter, we'll take it. Other one is also 1 centimeter, 1, same. As well as in an equilateral triangle, all these sides are equal. A, B, C. So here also if the length of one side is 2, then the other side is also 2, then here also it will be 2. So length of all these three sides are equal in the case of equilateral triangle. So that is known as perimeter of regular shapes. Perimeter of regular shapes. See, whenever we were talking about a regular shape, regular means the shape whose can be drawn on a plane, or that is two dimensional as well, all its sides are equal. Now here what we can do? Now with this only we can conclude the formula. Here in the square we have four sides. So the formula will become 4 into side. And here in our equilateral triangle we have three sides. So the formula for perimeter will become 3 into side. Quite simple. It shows if you have an hexagon, that will be 6 into side. That's it. Easy way to find it out formula. Yes. Now we'll come to a few examples we are going to do that is related to our plane figures. And after that we'll come to exercise, that is 10.1. So let's see example 6. Till example 5 we have already done in yesterday's class. Example 6. Find the distance traveled by Shaina if she takes 3 rounds of a square park of side 70 meter. So how much distance was covered by Shaina if she took 3 rounds of a square park of side 70 meter. Now side of a square park has been given to you. Side of a square park. What is the length of side? That is 70 meter. Now square formula we have done. So what will be perimeter of square park? That will be 4 into its side. So 4 will be multiplied by 70, that will become 280 meter. 4 sevens are 28 and 0 will be as it is, 280 meter. Now children will come to next question. Therefore, no, this question does not end here. The question says that find the distance travelled by Shaina if she takes 3 rounds of a square park. So with this we have find it out what is the perimeter of a square park. Now you are supposed to find it out that distance traveled in three rounds. So means whatever length of that particular square park length of all the four sides once, that will be multiplied by 3. 280. So what will be the distance traveled? That is 3 8 are 24 2 6 7 8 840 meter. Their cost is not there, 840 meter. So here length of that square park you will be getting in meter. Okay, now let's see one more question that is related to perimeter of a regular shape. That is, Pinky runs around a square field of side 75 meter. Bob runs around a rectangular field with length 160 meter and breadth 105 meter. Now, who covers more distance? Now, this also example is again interesting kind of a question, that here we were talking about in this example number 7, Pinky runs around. Pinky, a girl, runs around the square for field of side 75 meter. So square field whose side is, square field whose side is 75 meter. So side of a square field, we can write it down. Side of a square field. Side of a square field. Side of a square field. Okay. Or you can write it like one round, that will be square field, that is 4 multiplied by square field, that will be 4 into side. So what is the length of side of a square field? Okay, side of a square field is, that is 70 meter. Then perimeter of a square field, perimeter of a square feet, that will be 75 perimeter of a square field, that will be 4 into side. Formula we are going to write, that is 4 into side. What we find it out, perimeter of a square field, that is 4 into side, 4 into 75, that will become 300. Now Pinky runs around a square field and Bob runs around a rectangular field whose length and breadth have been given. So this distance will be covered by Pinky. Then perimeter of a rectangle, that we are going to find it out, which distance is covered by Bob. So now this distance, perimeter of a square field, is distance covered by Pinky. Distance covered by Pinky. Similarly, distance covered by Bob. That is, again, now Bob has a completed distance, that is your distance is of rectangular field. So that will become 2 into length plus breadth. So here length is given in the question. Length is given here 160 meter and breadth is 105. That you are going to add it on, and then you can find it out perimeter or distance covered by Bob, who is running on a rectangular field. Now, difference in the distance covered, so we'll find it out that. Now, this also again it is asked that who covers more distance and by how much. So, distance covered, like Bob has covered 2 into length plus breadth. So, that will become 2 into length is what? Length is 160 and 105. That is 265. So, this will become length of, or the total length or the distance covered by Bob. Distance covered by, that is Pinky. Fine? And then we'll find it out that here the length is 530. Now, meter. Now, comparison of these two perimeter or distance covered by Pinky or Bob, that is also going to compare. Now, difference in the distance covered. Difference in the distance covered, that is 530 minus 300, that will become 230 meter. Therefore, Bob covers more distance by 230 meter. Bob covers more distance by 230 meter. Again, that is example 7. Again, one more example in I'll read it out for you all, and then we will come to exercise. One more example is what? That is example 8. Find the perimeter of a regular pentagon. What I have told you now, rewind it back. Think about it. If we have pentagon, that formula of perimeter will become 5 into side. If one side is given, that is one side is 3 centimeter, then easily you can find it out that what will be the perimeter of this regular closed pentagon. So what do you mean by regular? Wherever we were using regular word, regular means that is equal. Fine? All the sides of that closed figure, that is equal, that is considered as regular closed figure. Then what do we mean by this? This kind of an place or this kind of an area, that is irregular. So if you remember that in smaller classes you have done two concepts also, regular and irregular, which can be like proper sides or equal sides will be there, that comes in regular. And there are certain sometimes we'll be having a certain distance which are not regular. Now the perimeter of a regular hexagon is 18 centimeter. How long is one side? Now again I have told you regular hexagon means all its six sides are equal. It means the perimeter which you have been given with then what you are going to do it, we are going to do division. That perimeter of a regular hexagon is 18 centimeter. How long is its one side? So, perimeter is 18 centimeter and a regular hexagon has 6 sides. So, this 18 will be divided by 6. You will be getting 3 centimeter. One side of a hexagon, that is 3 centimeter. Therefore, length of each side of a regular hexagon is 3 cm. Okay, so with this we have finished with the conceptual part of it. Conceptual part of it, and then we'll come to exercise. In exercise, first and foremost important question is example is exercise 10.1. Question number 1. You can find it out many regular and irregular shapes. Some of the times that you won't be able to know that what is the formula of this. So in that case, how we are able to find it out? How we are able to find it out? Perimeter of each of the following figures. Now here I am going to take one example, like one example we are going to take it. So four sides were there and you have been given 5 cm, 4 cm, then 1 cm and 2 cm. Now 5, 4, 2, 1. So what will be there that have to find it out perimeter of this. So you need not to worry about that how we are supposed to do formula. If you will be getting such kind of a figure, then perimeter is equal to sum of whatever figure will be given, sum of all its sides, sum of all its sides. It means you are going to add it. 5 plus 4, 9 plus 2, 11 plus 1, 13 centimeters. This will become perimeter of that first figure, first closed figure which is given in your book in exercise 10.1. Now question number 2, the lid of a rectangular box of side 40 cm and 10 cm and is sealed by round with tape. What is the least of the tape required? Now again rectangular boxes will be there. Now question number 1, where you will be getting all these figures? You can see in your book many figures have been drawn. You can see in your book here many figures have been drawn and you all are supposed to find it out only the perimeter of these figures. Side of or length is already mentioning here, that also you can find it out as well, and length. After doing this length, then now this regular shapes you are going to simply add it on. Whatever length have been given, that you are going to add it, whatever length. Like if you do not have any formula, a simple formula that you can see, that is, or that you can take it, that is sum of all its sides. Perimeter of each of the following figures. Perimeter means what? Perimeter means sum of all its sides. So children, next, in the next class we are going to start with question number 2 of exercise 10.1 as well. And interesting question is given in exercise 10.1. You can just add it on, add on all these, and then we'll start with question number 2. So here only I'm going to finish the class and you just go through it. You just go through rest of the thing, examples which we have done in this chapter, and then in the next class we will be starting that exercise 10.1. So exercise 10.1, and one more thing is there, like okay, fine. So that you all are going to do it, and then we will meet in the next class. And so that's all for today, children. Have a good day. And we'll start with exercise 10.1. Be ready in the next class to start exercise 10.1. Good day, children.